Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Whoever you are, wherever you are on life's journey, you are welcome right here at Eastminster Presbyterian Church, where you are loved and you matter. Well, congratulations to us. May God add a blessing to our partnership. All right, so many thanks to Aaron Cox Holmes and Michael Wilson, Session, Glenn Bloss, and the Pastor Nominating Committee, and thank you, kind congregation. So quickly, sometime in August, I knew that I'd be mentioning during the congregational meeting that kindness lives here and could be our focus in here and out there. Meantime, Clerk of Session and Dream Team leader Janice McCollum had the same vision. She was going to hand out small, kind bars on rally day. And I said, let's wait till September 15th. Well, the logistics didn't work with the congregational meeting, so as you leave church today, Janice McCollum and Tanya O'Hearn will give you a kind bar. Thank you, Janice, for buying them and getting them. For Janice. For everybody. Who has our joke this morning? Okay, here we go, Bob. He should have sat up front.
Yes, I should have. This is about a tractor salesman. How did he find out that his wife left him?
How did the tractor salesman find out that his wife left him?
He went home and she had left him a John Deere letter.
Ah! A John Deere letter. Very good. Very good. Love that. Following worship, come and enjoy friendship time in the NPR. Our flowers are given to the glory of God by Lois and Bill Moore in memory of their parents and in honor of their sons, their wives, and their grandchildren. Session has called a congregational meeting for next Sunday, 11 a.m., for the sole purpose of disbanding the pastor nominating committee. Ah! We thank the Bells of Eastminster this morning, Congregational Life Elder Barb Leimeyer, our ushers, and our camera operator, Fred Becker. Let's take a moment now to breathe in lots of welcome. And breathe out and spread lots of welcome. Now, let us enjoy why we have this firm foundation. As you are able, will you please rise for our call to worship? God, you call each of us to serve you, and we answer,
here I am.
Jesus, you call each of us to follow you, and we answer,
here I am.
Holy Spirit, you call each of us to worship you this day, and we answer,
here I am.
Beautiful, beautiful. You may have a seat. I saw some wet eyes in there.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Would those who Would those who have stated their desire to join in this household of faith please come forward and bring your bulletin. Julie Michael has also been welcomed by Session, and she will be presented in a reception of new members on October 13th. On behalf of the Session, I present Janice Watt and Steve Marsh, who have been received into the membership of this congregation by transfer from Paxton Presbyterian Church's congregation. On behalf of the Session, I present Joan Klinke and Leslie Wiles, who have been received into the membership of this congregation by reaffirmation of faith. Joan. As members of the body of Christ, let us all stand and reaffirm the faith into which we were baptized.
It's in your bulletin.
Together,
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You may be seated. We have professed our faith as one body. At this time, I ask you, will you be a faithful member of this congregation, share in its worship and mission through your prayers and gifts, your study and service, and so fulfill your calling to be a disciple of Jesus Christ? If so, say, I will with God's help.
I will with God's help.
I invite the congregation to raise your hand in blessing. Holy God, thank you for calling us to be your people and joining us to Christ's body, the church. We praise you for leading Steve and Jan, Joan and Leslie to this congregation. Empower us by your Spirit that we might love one another as Christ loved us, honoring him in all that we say and do, giving our lives in service to others through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We are so glad that you made the decision to join this community. It is hoped that you will be comfortable here and a little uncomfortable too, for the gospel confronts us as well as comforts us. We hope you will experience at Eastminster Presbyterian Church a balance of the gospel's peace and the gospel's continuing call for self-examination. Lastly, remember your baptism and be thankful and know that the Holy Spirit is at work within you.
Welcome to this ministry that we share in Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Peace be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pass and receive the peace with our many neighbors. Appropriate for a membership Sunday, right? Thank you, Bells of Eastminster and Randy. I can wait. In today's passage, we're at the beginning of Jesus' ministry. It opens with John the Baptist, who had baptized Jesus the day before. The next day, John again was standing with two of his disciples, and as he watched Jesus walk by, he exclaimed, "Look, here is the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard him say this, and they followed Jesus. When Jesus turned and saw them following, he said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and see." They came and saw where he was staying, and they remained with him that day. It was about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. One of the two who heard John speak and followed him was Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. He first found his brother Simon and said to him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated anointed. He brought Simon to Jesus, who looked at him and said, "You are Simon, son of John. You are to be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable and pleasing in your sight, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Jesus asks them, "What are they looking for?" I love this. That's where you begin with religion. What are you looking for? What are you seeking? Some say joy. Others say liberation. Maybe you're looking for forgiveness. Some say hope, a way out of despair. And others say, "I'm looking for love." I bet most people would say peace. Don't you think? Don't you think? We can be so restless, so worried, so stressed. So to have peace down in our heart, a place of calm and rest, a sanctuary inside of us, isn't that what most of us are looking for? Calm from the storm? How wonderful to have a place inside you that no matter what happens, in here, is peace. And that's the peace of Christ that passes all understanding, and you know it. Peace, peace, peace. Jesus said that all of the time, didn't he? Be not afraid. Peace, be not afraid. I give you my peace. Peace. He wants you to have his peace. What are you looking for?
Peace.
Peace. What are you looking for? He asked them. These two weren't quite sure what Jesus meant. But their prior leader had just identified Jesus as the Lamb of God. So they're like, "Where are you staying? We want to know more. We want more of you." And Jesus, ever the inviter, goes, "Come and see." Isn't that the best? He's not telling them everything right at the beginning. Oh, you just come and see. It's only 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We got to get through a little bit of evening. Come and see. Come and stay with me. When Jesus invites you to come and see, you don't have to know everything that means. You just want to know more. What might he have for you? Probably some answer that's going to help you in your daily living. After all, he's the Messiah, the anointed one. Who else would you go to? Who else would you want to stay with? Come and see Jesus, the one who grants peace. We want more of you. More of you, Jesus. You know, sometimes members say they aren't sure they believe in God. It's important to admit your truth wherever you are on life's journey. So I'm always so grateful when someone shares that truth. You know, I don't really know if I believe. Maybe I believe, I'm not sure. If you don't believe or you're not sure, maybe it's like being where these first two disciples are, meeting Jesus for the first time. A popular Christian scholar, Marcus Borg, wrote a wonderful, well-known book, Meeting Jesus Again for the First Time. Come and see. Come and see. Come and meet Jesus again for the first time. You think you know Jesus? Come and meet him again for the first time. Come and see. Come and see. You'll find community. The prerequisite for community is to come to church. Join in and belong. To have community means you have something in common with the people. What we have in common at EPC is Christ. Our unity is in Christ. Can we celebrate that? Yes, our unity is in Christ. It isn't really in one another. We can't provide that. It's in Christ. How firm a foundation, right? Jesus is so excited that we added to our numbers today. He's like, come and see. Come and see, new people. Come and see this new thing I am doing at EPC. We don't even know yet where he's going to take us, but we're going to come and see. We're going to trust the journey that we're on and trust what Jesus will do in our boards, committees, and sessions. We're at a new beginning. We're at a new season. Come and see. Come and see. I am so very grateful for the spirit of unity that we have in this church. Unity is a gift of God. So thank you, God. Unity is not of our own making. This unity that we have came from God. Thank you, God. So, what can help encourage church unity? Showing love, kindness, forgiveness, compassion, and service. And one more thing, too. Let's remember and accept that no one of us here is perfect. And we don't have to be. Our church isn't perfect, and it doesn't have to be. Christ doesn't call us to be perfect. He calls us to be faithful. Right? We're not called to be perfect. You can mess up. The church can mess up. The church doesn't have to be the greatest thing in the world. We just have to be faithful. Okay? He forgives us. Let's forgive each other when we don't measure up to how we think the other should be. You know, so-and-so, they're not really measuring up to how I think they should be. You know that Pastor Suze, I don't really like what she did the other day. Well, you better forgive her, she said to. With that said, we do have a behavior covenant. We have to have boundaries for how we treat one another. We have a pretty large community. We gotta make sure we're not stepping on toes too much. Have to be careful what we say, right? What we say. Linda, zip it, right? Be careful. But at the end of the day, even without a behavior covenant, because Jesus on the cross told his Father to forgive us, when we can forgive each other, even on a daily basis, that's when we're truly Christ's body. No questions asked, unconditional forgiveness. He unconditionally forgave us. So when somebody rubs you the wrong way, maybe give them the benefit of the doubt. Remember Jesus and his forgiveness. I think I'm gonna forgive him today. I want to be in Christ's body. I want to be in community, and that means I have to forgive. Let's be a kind, grace-bearing people, right? It feels so much better in your body to be kind and grace-bearing than to be all, I'm so mad. And then, when people out there want to know more about you, you can say, come and see. And when they come here, when you bring them here because you've said, come and see, what they will find, as each one of our new members told Session this past Monday night, and Session was so in love with this, is just how friendly you are. Each of the five talked about it. They witnessed their experience of you. Friendliness goes a long way. Let me tell you, not every church is known for their friendliness. The thing I have most often heard in my long ministry is people say, I worshiped at such and such church and no one said anything to me. People want to belong where there is kindness and joy and opportunities to serve. Whatever isn't perfect around here, I just trust that God, it is God who brings about what God needs in his church. He doesn't need or want us to be perfect. He wants us to be faithful. He's going to bring about what he needs here at this spring. It's Berry. Is that how you say it? Yeah, it's been a year and I still can't say it. This spring is Berry Township. Let's not underestimate the power of God to work in the life of our church and to work in our own life. Never underestimate the power of God
to work in your own life. Oh, come and see. Community. Amen. Have a seat. May the gifts we offer to the God of new beginnings bring comfort to those who grieve, hope to those who live on the streets of despair, peace to all the broken places, and grace to all who long to draw closer to Him. Thank you.
join me in our prayer of dedication. Let us pray. We are called to be the embodiment of God's word. We are called to use our whole selves to care for creation, community, and the church. We share our financial gifts for the ministry and work of this community of faith and through our missions to the world. We accept our call to serve as a steward for God's gifts for the good of all. In Jesus' name, amen. Beth Magid has our minute for vision from our dive team.
Good morning. I am Beth Magid, and I'm speaking to you as a member of the dive team this morning. The dive team wants to update you on the new American Welcome Center and the Haitians, as well as address a few of the questions that we have been asked about their program. Our source is from the New American Welcome Center data. Haiti is approximately the size of Maryland, and the entire country has been declared a state of emergency. Some of the facts are as follows. In the first quarter of 2024, 2,500 Haitians were murdered or injured by gangs. 4.3 million people, which is one half of the population, face emergency levels of food scarcity and subsequent hunger. 362,000 people are homeless in Haiti due to conflict and disasters. Healthcare in Haiti is on the brink of collapse. 80,000 cases of cholera have been reported as of January 2024. Locally, there are currently 8,000 Haitians in York, and those numbers continue to grow. The New American Welcome Center at the YMCA is currently serving 1,700 clients and their families. At least 300 of the families have arrived since spring, and the center continues to get new families each week with many requests and many needs. The Haitians have arrived in York because they have the name of someone who will assist them. At Border Patrol, the refugees must have an address, and then assistance organizations will help secure them transportation. The New American Welcome Center, with the leadership of Deb Detzel and Kim Felix, has done an amazing job of helping these refugees. York is now on the map as a hospitable destination where people can find resources, services, housing, and jobs. If you speak to any of our EPC members or friends of EPC who have visited or volunteered at the New American Welcome Center, you will hear about the gratitude, the respectfulness, the politeness, and the joy of the Haitian people. Check your bulletin in the next 2 weeks for information on how you can help with your time, your talents, and your resources at the New American Welcome Center. Thank you.
Thank you, Beth. May God add a blessing to our ministry to the Haitian community, and we pray for Haiti today. We'll include them. As we move into a time of prayer, you are invited to close your eyes. Relax. Let go of everything. And just breathe. Breathe. If you'd like, you can gently drop your right ear over your right shoulder, and with your right arm, hold on to your left arm right above the elbow and feel an extra bit of stretch. Breathe. Let go. And gently come back up And gently drop your left ear over your left shoulder. And with your left arm, hold on to your right arm, right above the elbow for the stretch. And breathe. And breathe. And come back up. With eyes still closed, if you'd like, send kindness to your feet. Send kindness to those knees. Send kindness to your hips. Send kindness to your lower back, to your belly. Send kindness to your chest. Send kindness to your upper back and shoulders. Wherever it is tight, send kindness. Send kindness to your face. Send kindness to the top of your head. You are a kind person. In the presence of God, share with Him now about a joy or concern. In the silence of rest. We thank you for receiving our prayers. We thank you for the gift of our life, for life itself. We thank you for our body. Thank you for being with us this glorious Sabbath day, for receiving all the things on our mind and in our heart, and for being with our body. We thank you for this season of transition from autumn to transformation of all kinds. Dear God, it is a season of transition for session, boards, committees, and teams. Help each of them to ease in gently as everyone gets to know the new members of those committees. Grant the boards and committees and teams and session ease, care, and laughter, that laughter will unite. We pray for these loved ones, Tim and family, Terry, Bob S., Ian S., Bill M., Kathy L., Richard Jr. We pray for Haiti. We continue to pray for Israel, Gaza, and the West Bank, Ukraine and Russia, the United States of America, and the establishment of your peace and light worldwide. In the name of our peacemaker and light bearer, we pray as he taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Go into God's world aware of God's call on your life, in your life. Follow our Lord Jesus Christ, who will lead you in paths of service and hope. Lean on the power of the Holy Spirit to give you courage and strength. May peace, joy, and love flow through you to others. In God's name, amen.